class 9th. Today we will be continuing with the revision of chapter number 2. And today's topic is utility. For this you can follow page number 1919. Now utility. Class 9th, in the previous class I have explained you the meaning of utility. I hope that you remember, but if you don't remember, let's just give it a revision. See, the word utility in economics generally refers to the measurement of usefulness that consumers obtain from any goods. Anything which satisfies human wants directly or indirectly, it's said to possess a utility. See, utility means usefulness. Utility means the want satisfying power of any commodity. Like example, chocolate. Somebody is wanting to have chocolate. Somebody wants to have chocolate. For that person, the utility of that chocolate can be a lot. But somebody who does not like chocolates, or somebody who does not feel to have it, for that person, the utility of chocolate will be zero. Correct. Next example, alcohol. The person who is an alcoholic, for that person, the usefulness or the utility of alcohol is a lot. But the person who does not consume alcohol, for that, the utility of alcohol will be zero. Third example, medicines. Person suffering from fever will have high utility for medicine. But the person who is fit, fine, healthy will have zero utility for medicines. Right. So I hope that with these examples, meaning of utility will be clear to you, which means that utility means want satisfying power. Want satisfying power. Any commodity which has this power to satisfy somebody's want, somebody's desire, somebody's need, somebody's demand is utility. Correct. Next we have is characteristics of utility. First, utility is not inherited with the commodity, which means that utility is associated with the commodity, but it is not inherited with it. If it were so, then everybody will get the same amount of satisfaction. Means, utility is not inherited with the commodity. Satisfaction is not there in the commodity. If you are consuming something, that doesn't mean that it will satisfy you in the same amount it has satisfied somebody else. Or if somebody else is satisfied with cigarette or alcohol, it might it's not compulsory that everyone will be satisfied with cigarette or with alcohol in the same manner. Second, utility is not associated with goodness. Means, the goods which provide satisfaction to the person may not always be welfare oriented or provide benefit. Means, utility does not mean that it is always going to be good for you, for me, for everyone. Correct. For example, when a person is disappointed with life and wishes to commit suicide, then he may take poison to end his life. Thus, the medicine which ends up his life provides him satisfaction. And on the other hand, it is very harmful for him. So, similarly, the cigarette is harmful but provides satisfaction to a man who is addicted to it. As I've told you that it is not related with goodness. If something is satisfying you, that does not mean that it is good for you, for me, for anybody. Third, utility is not pleasure. Utility is not pleasure means it is not related with pleasure at all. Okay, it does not mean that if I am having chocolate, I am having pleasure. I am having medicine, I am having pleasure. No. Usefulness means a person who has just got heart attack. The utility is that he has to be admitted in the ICU as soon as possible. So, it is not related with goodness. Correct. It is not related with pleasure, because it is, because at that point of time it is the demand of the situation that the person needs to be admitted in the ICU. So it is not related with pleasure at all. It means something which is to be taken according to the situation. Utility is not is a relative concept. Utility is a relative concept means that it differs from person to person, place to place, and situation to situation. Right? Example. Today, we are sitting at home because of COVID-19, and we are teaching and studying virtually. The utility is very high, right? But once the schools will be reopened or we will be there in the school premises, we will not take these virtual classes. We will take live classes. We will be there talking to each other face to face. Correct. So it is situation to situation. It is different from situation to situation. Today the situation is different. Sometimes the situation will be different. And according to that, the utility will also be different. Now, fifth is, we will do sixth point actually, that is subjective. Utility is subjective. Utility is subjective because it depends upon the customer's satisfaction. As I have told you, somebody is satisfying himself with alcohol and cigarette, but somebody might not be satisfied with alcohol and cigarette, right? Somebody is satisfied with Karela juice. Somebody might not be satisfied with Karela juice. Somebody is satisfied with two fulkas, two chapatis. Somebody might not be satisfied with two chapatis. So it is subjective because it depends from person to person. It depends from person's satisfaction. That what is satisfying the person, and as to how much, as to what limit it is satisfying the person. Seventh point, immeasurable. Utility is immeasurable. Means you cannot measure utility. You have had four chapatis, right? You are full, you are happy now. But you cannot tell how much happiness. You cannot tell what percent happiness. You cannot tell out of 10 how much percent or how many numbers will you give to the happiness that you have consumed with the consumption of chapatis. So it is immeasurable. You cannot add or you cannot subtract to it. You cannot measure it in any quantity, in any unit. Right? Then we have is usefulness. It means that goods possesses utility even when they may not be useful. In other words, harmful goods always have utility because it is useful for the man who is habitual for, who is habitual to it. Right? Somebody who has a habit of taking bad things will have great utility for those bad things because he is habitual to it. Right? Somebody who consumes tea, who has a habit of having tea 4 times a day, will have great utility for that tea. But person who does not have a habit of having tea so much will have zero utility for that. Right? We will not do classification of utility. We will not do measurement of utility, though in a very small, in a very brief, I am going to explain you this cardinal and ordinal approach. We will not do market, we will not do income, we will not do value, right? We will not do characteristics of value, we will not do price, we will not do services, we will not do savings, wealth. Characteristics of wealth will be taught to you in brief, right? There are many things which are exempted, which we will not be doing in this chapter. So that I will not be covering those. I will be just covering those things which are important. And you also learn those things which are important. Correct. Please do not create any havoc. Please do not panic sitting at homes and troubling your parents and troubling we people also, because we are doing only those things which are important. The things which are not covered in any of the video means it is not important and you can leave that topic. You are free to leave that topic. All right. In सिंपल एंड क्लियर लैंग्वेज आई एम टेलिंग यू, इन एनी वीडियो इफ एनी टॉपिक इज नॉट कवर्ड इट मीन्स इट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड यू आर फ्री टू लीव दैट टॉपिक. करेक्ट. सो वील सी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. टिल देन यू जस्ट रिवाइज एवरीथिंग, यू जस्ट स्टडी वट सो एवर इज बीन टॉट. ऑल राइट, एंड टेक केयर, स्टे सेफ, स्टे होम. बाय बाय.